गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ एच डी पवार, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, गोखले पीयू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेलगाम। लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द टॉपिक परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटेटिव मार्केट। टुडे वी शैल स्टडी व्हाट इज प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ सप्लाई। You have already done what is price elasticity of demand. It is on the same lines. Instead of the term demand, you are going to use the term supply here. Price elasticity of supply measures the responsiveness of quantity supplied to change in price of the good. That means supply is dependent on price, and whenever there is change in the price, whenever there is rise or decrease, rise or fall in the price, there is going to be change in the price. That is, there may be increase and decrease in the supply also. That is, when price rises, supply increases; price falls, supply decreases. So we have only studied this much in law of supply, but price elasticity measures the responsiveness, that is how much it responds to the change in the price, by what quantity or by what percentage there is a change in the quantity supplied to the change in the price, and that measuring of that responsiveness of quantity supplied by the supplier to the change in price is called as price elasticity of supply. It is defined as percentage change in quantity supplied as a percentage change in its price. That is, if the price is changing by 1%, how much the quantity supplied, by what percentage the quantity supplied is changing. So it is defined as percentage change in quantity supplied as a percentage change in its price, and PES, that is price elasticity of supply, is written in the form of a formula as what? Percentage change in quantity supplied of a good divided by percentage change in price of a good. Example, let's take an example, as we have taken in case of demand also. Example, when price of a good is rupees 10, the goods sold is 200 units. When the price is 10, the goods supplied are 200 units. If the price rises to rupees 30, the goods supplied increases to 1000 units. So if there is a rise in the price by to rupees 30, there is a increase in the supply to 1000 units. What is price elasticity of supply? Solution, the same formula, it is change in quantity divided by change in price into original price upon original quantity, same as in case of demand, same formula. Here only it is change in quantity supplied divided by change in price into original price of the goods and divided by original quantity supplied. Now here we have taken all the things that are given in the problem. Original quantity supplied is how much? 200 units. Original price is rupees 10. Change in quantity is always the changed quantity you will take first. That is, changed quantity is now how much? 1000 units minus original 200 units you get is 800 units. Then change in price is always the changed price minus the original price, that is 30 minus 10, that is equals to 20 rupees. Then you substitute these numbers in the formula, that is change in quantity is what? 1000 minus 200 is 800, divided by change in price is what? 30 minus 10 is 20 units, into original price is 10 units, divided by original quantity is 200. When you do the cancellation, you get answer 2. Therefore, the price elasticity is greater than 1. 2 is greater than 1. So when there is little change in the price, the quantity supplied has increased by more than 1, that is elasticity is greater than 1. Then types of elasticity of supplies, same like elasticity of demand, there are 5 types. They are same: perfectly elastic supply, then perfectly inelastic supply, more elastic supply, less elastic supply, unitary or equal elastic supply. That is, perfectly elastic supply is what? Here price elasticity is equals to infinity. Okay, it is equal to infinite. That is, a small change in the price may lead to a greater change in the quantity supplied. Okay, or then perfectly inelastic supply, that is, whatever may be the price, the supply remains the same, that is 0. More elastic supply, that is, small change in the price will lead to greater change in quantity supplied. Less elastic supply, that is, EP is less than 1, that is, a greater change in the price may lead to a smaller change in the quantity supplied. Elasticity is less than 1. Unitary or equal elastic supply, that is, same, the a percentage change in the price leads to same percentage change in the quantity supplied. EP is equals to 1. Here you need not have to explain the diagrams, you just have to mention the 5 types from your syllabus point of view. Just remember the types of elasticities of supply. Then we come to a problem, that is, compute in the sense calculate the TR, that is total revenue, marginal revenue MR, and AR, average revenue schedule, when market price of each unit of a good is rupees 10. Here price, see the problem that is given first, where there are 4 columns: quantity, TR, MR, and AR. Only quantity is given there as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and TR, MR, and AR, everywhere there is a dash or question mark which you need to calculate. The price column is not shown here in the chart, but it is mentioned in the problem. That is, when the market price of each unit of good is rupees 10. So price is given in the problem but not shown in the chart. Now solution, first you need to draw the quantity column, you need to show a price column. Okay, then TR, MR, and AR. So quantity is as given, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Price column, you write when the market price of each unit of good is rupees 10. So price is same there. In perfect competitive market, uniform price, whatever quantity is sold, the price remains the same. You write there 10, 10, 10, 10. Then you have to calculate the TR. So what is the formula to calculate TR? It's shown here, price into quantity. That is, first one, 0 into 10 will lead to 0 only, then 1 into 10 will give you 10, 2 into 10, 20, 3 tens are 30, 4 tens are 40, 5 tens are 50, 6 tens are 60. TR column is calculated. Then MR column, MR formula, you know, MR is equals to TRN minus TRN minus 1. Okay, so what is the TR first? You see TR is 0 there. Dash you have to write always for 0. Quantity, when quantity is 0, you write MR is dash or 0. Then when the quantity is 1, you see TR is 10. 10 minus 0, n minus 1, that is 10 minus 0 will give you 10. For the second unit, you see TR is 20, and that will be 20 minus 10, that is n minus 1, the previous one, n minus 1. 20 minus 10 will give you 10 again. For the third unit of quantity, it is what? 30 minus the second unit, that is 30 minus 20 will give you 10. For fourth unit of quantity, TR is 40. So 40 minus the previous unit, n minus 1 is 30. 40 minus 30 is 10. Similarly, for fifth and sixth, it will be 50 minus 40 will give you 10. 60 minus 50 will give you 10. So it is 10, 10 everywhere. Now you are getting MR and AR as 10, 10 only because the price is uniform. We have already done it. Then AR column, what is the formula? AR average revenue is per unit of quantity sold. Per unit of quantity sold, that is total revenue divided by the units of goods or quantity. So for first one, TR is 0 units, it is TR is 0 only. So 0, 0 only you are going to write. Then for the first unit of quantity, TR is 10. 10 divided by first unit, 1 unit sold is 1. 10 divided by 1 will give you 10. Then second unit, TR is what? 20. 20 divided by 2 units will give you again 10. 30 divided by 3, 10. 40 divided by 4, 10. 50 divided by 5 will give you again 10 units. 60 divided by 6 will give you 10 units. Okay. So, this problem, such kind of problems with the same figure or different figures may come for, they will come for 5 marks. So, you can score easily 5 marks here. So, you have understood the types of elasticities of supply. It is same like elasticity of demand. Only thing you have to write here, perfectly elastic supply, perfectly inelastic supply, more elastic supply, less elastic supply, and unitary or equal elastic supply. Then we have seen the price elasticity of supply, meaning that is it measures the responsiveness of quantity supplied to change in the price of the good. And a problem, just a minute. Let us deal with another question, last part of this lesson. Purposely I have kept it last. Market supply curve. Now you have also studied market demand curve. On similar terms, market supply curve is the aggregate, or it is the total quantity of goods produced and supplied in the market by all the sellers at a given price. Okay, so the total quantity supplied by all the sellers in the market put together is called as a market supply at a given price. Then assume there are only two suppliers in the market. For diagrammatic purpose, we are going to assume there are only two sellers in the market. Therefore, market supply of two firms. Now, each seller, like how each consumer is ready to demand a different quantity at different prices, same way here, two suppliers we are taking who are ready to supply different quantities at different prices. That is, the market supply curve of two firms is, now S1 is what? The supplier number 1, and S2 is supplier number 2. Now, at a given price, the quantity supplied by, here you see S1 is a function of P, where zero quantity will be supplied if price is less than 10. By supplier 1, 0 quantity will be supplied if price is less than 10, and P minus 10 will be supplied if the price is greater than or equal to 10. That is, supplier 1 is not ready to supply any quantity of goods if the price is less than 10, and if the price is more than or equal to 10, then he will supply P minus 10. Supplier 2, similarly, he is ready to supply 0 quantity if the price is less than 15. Okay, and if the price is greater than or equal to 15, he is ready to supply P minus 15. This, just see, it can be shown with the help of a diagram here. At a price less than P1, at a price less than 10 P1 will there will be no supply by any firm. Okay, because first seller is not ready to supply if the price is less than 10, and second seller is not ready to supply even if the price is less than 15. So when the price is P1 here, see in the diagram, just let me tell you, three diagrams are shown, three supply curves are shown in one only, where quantity is measured on or output is measured on x-axis, and on y-axis we are measuring the price. Then you see here P1, P2 and P3 on price y-axis, you see we are shown three price lines, P1, P2 and P3. Then here see, between 0 and P1 price line, the price is less than 10. Exactly at P1, price is equals to 10. Then between P1 and P2, that is price is less than 15 and price is equals to 15 exactly at P2. Then between P2 and P3, price is greater than or equal to 15. Okay, then Q, A, B, C diagrams. A denotes the supply curve of supplier number 1. Then B denotes S2 supply curve, which is the supply curve of the second supplier. And SM, C diagram denotes SM, that is supply of the market, entire market, that is a horizontal summation of S1 and S2 will give you SM. So here see, at a price less than P1, that is in bracket I have written, it is less than 10, no supply by any firm. Therefore, that is below P1, the supply market, the supply of a market, SM, that is supply of market, is 0. No supply will be done. So you see, the supply curve does not start from 0. Then in between P1 and P2, the price is what? Greater than 10. Then here, firm A is willing to supply for normal profits. Only firm A is willing to supply for normal profits if price is equal to or greater than 10. So you see, the supply curve of A starts from P1. Then firm B is not ready to supply at a price between P1 and P2 because it is not ready to supply if price is less than 15. Okay, so it is the supply of a market is only the market supply of firm A. Firm A is ready to supply when price is greater than 10, but supply curve does not start yet of supplier number 2, because he is ready to supply only if the price is greater than or equal to 15. Then you see, price in between P2 and P3 is what? It shows a price greater than 15. Here both firm A and firm B supply the goods, and the market supply is equals to what? Quantities Q3. Here that is Q1 quantity is supplied by supplier 1, Q2 quantity is supplied by supplier 2, and Q3 denotes the market supply, which is Q1 plus Q2. Quantity supplied by Q1 plus quantity supplied by Q2 will give you Q3, that is S1 plus S2 will give you SM. Okay, so here it shows the price. You see, on one more time, price is measured on y-axis, and quantity or output sold by the supplier is measured on x-axis. Then three price lines are shown, that is P1, P2 and P3. Between 0 and P1, the price is less than 10, no supply by both the firms. Then P is bit at exactly at P1, P is equals to 10, price is equals to 10, where supplier 1 is ready to supply for normal profit. So supply curve of supplier 1 starts from P1. Then between P1 and P2, price is less than 15, where supplier number 2 is not ready to supply. So the supply curve of a market is only the supply curve of the first supplier. Then when the price is between P2 and P3, price is greater than or equal to 15, supplier 1 is of course ready to supply. He is supplied it even when price is equals to 10. So supply curve just extends and it reaches S1. Then supply curve of second firm begins where the price is equals to 15 at P2 and it extends to S2. So here in the third one, third diagram where supply market, you see first only one short supply curve is there, that is market supply of firm A. Market supply of firm A is only the market supply curve of first supplier is only the market supply here, short curve. Then both the suppliers are supplying at when price is equal to or greater than 15. So another supply curve which starts from P2 onwards, and it shows the Q1 plus Q2 quantity supplied, which leads to Q3, that is S1 plus S2 supply curve leads to the supply curve of the market. And today this is the end of the perfect competitive chapter. Hope you have followed it. Thank you.